Hi there, I'm Phil from DataStacks, and this is how to build a RAG application with GenKit and AstroDB. Now, GenKit is a framework built by the Firebase team to make it easy to build generative AI applications. It has a bunch of great features like a unified API for working with large language models, a local developer UI for quick experimentation and running evaluations, and easy monitoring of your application in production. GenKit also makes it easy to build RAG applications, making embedding, indexing, and retrieving just part of the framework's primitives. And so with the AstroDB GenKit plugin, you can quickly integrate AstroDB's vector database into a GenKit application. So let's build a RAG application just to see how. So the first thing you need is a database. So I signed into my AstroDB account, and I've created a database and a collection called RAG that has a vector index with 768 dimensions. 768 dimensions is the number of dimensions of the vectors that Google's text embedding 004 model will create. In order to access this collection, I need my API endpoint and an application token, as well as the collection name. And we'll also need an API key from for Gemini, so you can get that from Google AI Studio. Just generate an API key here. Let's take a look at the application. Here we've got some imports for some GenKit dependencies. So we've got the main GenKit function. We've got some Google AI dependencies from the Google AI plugin and AstroDB functions from the AstroDB plugin. We've got some other dependencies that we'll use later on down the code. So the first thing you need to do is configure your GenKit instance. So we tend to create an AI object here using the GenKit function. And here is where you add in the plugins that you want to use. This is a relatively simple app, so we've just got one plugin for Google AI that's going to give us access to models and vector embedding models. And then AstroDB will give us access to the collection that we created. And here is where you set up the client parameters and the credentials to use the applications, the API endpoint and the application token, the collection name, and then the embedder we'll use, which is text embedding 004 from the Google AI plugin. Once you've created this AI function, AI object, you can then get access to the AstroDB indexer and retriever using the AstroDB indexer ref and AstroDB retriever ref functions and the collection name again. And those indexer and retriever functions will allow us to both put things into the database and then get them out of the database. Next up, we need to create a flow. Now, flows in GenKit are collections of behavior of things you need to do, a bit like a function, but they make it available for the GenKit UI to use. Flows are very well defined. They have good input schemas and output schemas with ZOD. So if you saw Z function being imported earlier, ZOD is here for input and output schemas. And then you can do other things as well. So we have this function to fetch text from the web. This just scrapes some text off of a web page. And you can run it within this AI.run function. And that allows the GenKit UI to kind of set trace points and understand exactly what's going on throughout the course of this little pipeline here. So we're extracting text from the web. We are turning that into chunks, turn those chunks into documents, and then index those documents in the database. So the AI.index function takes the indexer, in this case, the AstroDB indexer, and a bunch of documents, and inserts them all into the database. Our next flow is our RAG flow. So this is where you get a user query come in, we search that query against the database, and then use the context from the database to generate the results. So we have another input schema and output schema, both strings on the input and output here. And we use the AI.retrieve function with the retriever set to be the AstroDB retriever, the query from the user, and then some other options like how many documents to return. In this case, I've just got 5. Once we've got the documents, we then use AI.generate with the model, in this case, Gemini 2.0 Flash, and the prompt with the query and the documents in it, and ultimately return the text. Now, we've defined this set of RAG functions in under 100 lines of code, which I think is pretty cool. And I've just started the application down here, which means we can go and use it in the browser here. So this is the GenKit UI. It shows us all of the kind of objects that we've created that you can use in your application. So there's things like models, which actually in this case come from the Google AI plugin, as well as the embedders. There's the flows we created, and there's the indexer and retriever. So let's start with the RAG flow. Let's see if we can ask this model a question. Let's ask it something it's not going to know, like which film won Best Picture at the Oscars in 2025? Reasonable question, but it's beyond the training date of Google Gemini, so it won't know. And it says it cannot be answered from the context provided. And that's correct. So what we can do is go to our flows, and in this case, go to our index web page flow. And this one, we can get a URL. So let's grab the URL for the Wikipedia page for the 2025 Oscars, pop that in there and run that flow. And that is going to go scrape the data off of the URL, send it into chunks, turn the chunks into documents and ingest those into AstroDB. We don't get an output from that, but we do know that we can go back to our flows, back to RAG, and ask that same question again. Which film won the 2025 Oscar for Best Picture? This time, because we're using a RAG flow and because we've got the information in the database, it knows that the film Anora won the 2025 Oscar for Best Picture. Now, I mentioned earlier that you can also look at these traces. And so if you look at the view trace here, you can see exactly what happened in the course of this flow. So we can see that the input was the question, the output was the correct answer. And as we look down the flow here, you can see where we went and retrieved the documents from the database for this. You can see where we created the vector embedding, and you can see where the generation happened with the Gemini API. And so that's all really useful. So building flows with GenKit and then testing them out in the UI is straightforward and feels really productive. And you can then call on these flows inside your own application. The AstroDB plugin for GenKit makes it really easy to add a vector database to GenKit. And there are links in the description to a tutorial and all the code so you can look into this in more detail. I hope you enjoy using GenKit and the AstroDB plugin. Let me know in the comments what you're building.